Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Just before we start rolling the cameras, just a quick announcement. Once your son's got an award, Ladies and gentlemen, parents and families, and all those watching our live stream at home, teachers and students in classrooms, parents, special guests, and the recording crew here with us in the hall, welcome to the 62nd Asquith Boys High School presentation ceremony for 2022. My name is Craig Phillip, and I will be your MC for today's event. In the interest of maintaining the flow and quality of the event, could the guests in the hall please ensure that electronic devices are switched to silent? And would all those present in the hall please stand for the entrance of, for the national anthem? Please be seated. Welcome to the student leadership team, who will be your compares for this ceremony. I'll now hand you over to our school captain, Josh Hegarty.
Thank you, Mr. Phillip. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our 62nd Annual Presentation Day ceremony. My name is Joshua Hegarty, and it is my privilege to have been elected school captain of Asquith Boys High School for 2022. As such, I, along with Vice Captain Elliot Rossington and Senior Prefect Luke Hansworth, will be your host today. I would now like to invite Mitchell Heaton to say the acknowledgement to country.
As a proud Camilleroy man, and on behalf of Asquith Boys High School, I like to acknowledge the Darug people to the west and the Kurungi people to the east as the traditional owners of the land that this ceremony is being conducted on. We recognise their continuing connection to the land and waters and thank them for protecting this land since the dreaming. We pay our respects to elders past and present and extend that respect to any First Nations people watching today. Always was, always will be Aboriginal land.
This is the third live stream of our Presentation Day ceremony and is a very special occasion for all of us. A sincere welcome to students, parents and friends, and special guests from the local and wider community. Whether you are joining us in the hall or online, I'd like to thank you all for your continued commitment to our school. Today we welcome Mr. Julian Lesser, MP, Member for Barara, the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddick, Mayor of Hornsby Shire Council, Petty Officer David McCubbin, Ms. Dawn Kilkelly, President of the PNC Association, Mr. Christopher Kent, President of the ABHS Old Boys, Senior Constable Lewis Peters, Police Youth Command, PCYC, Mr. Dennis Hogan, representing the Rotary Club of Hornsby, Mr. Jamie Roberts, representing Hornsby Lions Club, Mr. Vo, the pharmacist of the Hornsby Curry Chemist, and Dr. Bill Holland, the owner of the Hornsby 24/7 Gym. This ceremony is about celebrating the wonderful achievements of the Asquith Boys High School. We will recognise their achievement in areas of academia, sport, citizenship, community service and culture, which this year have been particularly outstanding. We would like to especially thank all of our supporters who have generously provided prizes for the boys, even if they cannot be with us today. We would now like to invite our principal, Mr. Bryce Grant, to give his principal's address for 2022.
Thank you. Thank you, Josh, and thank you, Mitch. Well done, Mitch. Very impressive. I begin today by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land on which we gather, and I pay my respects to the elders, past and present, and I extend that respect to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people here with us today. Good morning to students, staff, award winners, parents, and special guests who have been invited, and more importantly, able to join with us this morning. We will be streaming this presentation day assembly to all our classrooms and the external community so that those who couldn't attend will be able to watch and view this special occasion. To all guests present or joining us via streaming, welcome to our 62nd annual presentation day, where we acknowledge and celebrate all the excellent school and student achievements for 2022. I am excited this morning. This is the first time that we are sharing as a whole school community our new school values, respect, responsibility and excellence. And we congratulate our banner design winners who entered our competition earlier this term, Evan Parise and Archie Robinson, both of Year 8, for their designs. Despite some of the challenges presented to our students and teachers over the past 12 months, once again as a school and community, it is fair to state that we have all risen to the challenges and again zeroed in on the major focus to educate and support all of our students, both in and out of the classroom. I am excited to be able to celebrate and acknowledge all that our students have achieved in 2022, be that academic, sporting, or in leadership at Asquith Boys High School over the past 12 months. Despite all the adversity that was presented and placed in front of the entire Asquith Boys High School community over the past 2 years, it is fair to assess and state that collectively as a community, everyone has excelled under these circumstances, working together to stay safe and support each other through some challenging and difficult stages. Despite the implications and the regular disruptions to the daily flow of study patterns and school life over the last 12 months, when I reflect, I'm extremely proud of the entire school community on the way that everyone has been able to respond to all the challenges and adjustments that were often received and then published in the very short term. We eagerly await on Thursday our Year 12 HSC results, and some of them are joining us today, so thank you for joining us, Year 12. It is important that we give a special mention to our outgoing Year 12s on their unique and caring support that they demonstrated and showed for each other during any period across the 2 years. We are excited that 25 of them have nominated for school recommendations early entry scheme to universities, and so far we've had 8 confirmed entry at Macquarie Uni. Also in Year 12 cohort, we acknowledge Kieran Heap and Nick Reid, who both received the honour of their major works being nominated for INTECT, the Major Work Showcase for Industrial Technology. In 2022, we also had the return of grade and competitive sport. This enabled our school to excel. We finished second in the zone cross country with Rory McFarlane, Kobe Jenkins, Alex Brendel, all qualifying for CHS cross country. At the Zone Athletics Carnival, again, we finished second with Sayo Anasio, Ethan Oliver, named as Zone Age Champions. And our 12 years 4x100 relay team of Alex Miller, Sayo Anasio, Marley and Kobe Jenkins finished fifth in the CHS finals. In knockout sport competitions, our soccer team narrowly lost to Narrabeen Sports High, and our KO baseball side were regional champions before being defeated by Fig Tree High in the quarterfinals of the CHS, an outstanding overall performance. And we also had extensive success at League Tag Gala Days in 2022. In our winter grade sport, we achieved an incredible 8 grade winter zone grand finalist teams, with the 14s rugby, 14 Bs and 15 A's soccer being victorious. However, the most incredible demonstration of school spirit occurred during the semi-finals, where our fourth placed 13A soccer team secured a victory over the first place Epping side. It was not so much about the victory, but about the unique spirit displayed by the Opens and 14s teams who watched at the venue and cheered the 13s to victory. engulfing the 13s players after that final whistle in what was a very special moment for everyone that was present. As the smallest school within the zone competition, we continued to succeed despite our size and due largely to the passion and dedication of our wonderful coaches. To them, I say thank you on behalf of the school and students for your time and dedication. We've also had individual sporting success in 2022. Boston Cameron achieved city selection for New South Wales Rugby Union Championships and is currently on tour in Ireland. Cy Jason, the 14s Outrigger National Champion, Heath Cameron, New South Wales Futsal Championship selection, and Mac Tunton, New South Wales Ice Hockey Championship selection. As well, Riley and Ethan Scott Brannigan were crowned CHS champions. And Ethan was not only captain of this team, but was selected for nationals in the New South Wales side and has been nominated for a CHS Sporting Blues Award. This in 2022 from a student body from year 7 to 12 have been exceptional, ensuring that your learning and your educational growth and development continued throughout the year. As well as celebrating our strong individual academic performance in 2022, it's worth noting that the introduction of our mobile phone policy, off and away, has proven highly successful with increasing student engagement and focus within the classroom. With only a handful of repeat offenders, students have generally embraced and respected this policy and its overall aim to enhance learning by minimising classroom distractions. It is important at this time that to our community that we acknowledge and farewell the contribution of a number of staff who are left or leaving at the end of this term. These include the earlier retirement of Mr. Blackwood after 25 years service at Asquith Boys High School, Mr. Gary McEwen, our school counsellor, Mr. Marcus Canny on transfer, and Miss Elsie Young, who has been seconded to the Department in Policy Development and Writing for the next 18 months, all of whom will be missed and have been dedicated contributors to your son's education while at Asquith Boys High School. With these changes come new staff appointments, and in 2022, we have already welcomed back Ms. Jackson and Mr. McGowan in TAS. And it's nothing short of miraculous to have not only one qualified engineering teacher in the school, but two. In 2023, we welcome Ms. Jess Thang in Maths, Mr. Craig Freeman in TAS, and Mr. Ethan Brown in English. Our school to work and construction classes continue to construct and design new projects this year. They completed plant boxes, the grandstand for the futsal court, Kappa stage and the reception area seating, as well as planning out new garden beds. And we thank Mr. Robson and Mr. Moskos for their participation and coordination of this program. I'd also like to acknowledge and thank Mr. Darwin, Mr. McGowan, Mr. Blackwood and Ms. Jackson for their time and efforts with their construction classes in completing, planning and organising the construction of numerous retaining walls and garden beds along the school oval and around Room 1, while also acknowledging the PNC for their assistance with some of the funding for these initiatives. This year, our prefects proudly continued our tradition of representing the school at Anzac Day services. And this week, all students from 7 to 11 will attend Wellbeing Days for their as a reward for their efforts in learning and personal growth over the last 12 months. And last week, it was exciting to have the return of our annual Walkathon, a successful day of fundraising and celebrating community spirit as this year comes to an end. With many other academic, sporting, community, fundraising, camps and leadership opportunities that cancelled or placed on hold or postponed in the last 12 months, I look forward to the return of many more curricular and extracurricular activities in 2023. To not only showcase our students and their many talents, but to reaffirm the excellence reputation Asquith Boys High School students continue to grow within the broader community. In 2023, we look forward to the return of the highly anticipated Year 10 ski trip. And excitedly, we're reviewing and planning proposals for two international tours in 2024, one for football and the other for a senior history. However, today, just as importantly, we celebrate our students who have excelled academically, continuing to impress by their willingness to participate and desire to be the very best they can be. Even the brightest among us, there's always something more to learn. And this is only possible due to the dedication, generosity, and professionalism of our passionate teaching staff, who are committed to ensuring excellent learning opportunities for our boys, always providing that bit extra for their students as extraordinary educators. Today, I'd also like to acknowledge and thank all parents for your involvement in the school and being wonderful advocates for all that we do at Asquith Boys High School, not only within the school, but within the local community. We thank the PNC committee for their generosity in 2022, and a special thank you to Miss Dawn Kelly as president for her support and service to the school over the past 3 years as president. A big thank you to all the parents who attended Zoom PNC meetings this year and your contribution to maintaining our extensive grounds, as well as the important purchase of faculty-required resources, including robots for science, signage in maths, laptop computers in English and HISI, PDHPE equipment, and a commercial-grade refrigerator for TAS, as well as a rehearsal and performance stage for Kappa. Your continuing support throughout the school by funding other initiatives like literacy and numeracy programs, the Year 7 PIP Awards, and the construction and planning of our GAN beds throughout the school is always greatly appreciated. I would also like to thank our outstanding and hardworking non-teaching support and administrative staff. We are extremely lucky to have a wonderful and talented team who are dedicated to the service of your sons and the staff at Asquith Boys High School. Finally, a big thank you to our organisers of this important event this morning, Ms Holder, Ms Beckerleg, Ms Christodoulou, Mr Timmons, Ms Henry, Mr Cabrera and Mr Phillip for them, and many, many others that I've left off there, for their preparation and organisation of today's ceremony. This morning, I'd like to call on Ms Holder to make a presentation to Ms Beckerleg for her tireless work, not only for Presentation Day, but also the many other administrative areas that she's contributed to over the years. Ms Beckerleg.
We love you. We owe you so much.
That's so beautiful.
That's so beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you. 2023 brings an exciting year for Asquith Boys High School. As an educational facility committed to excellence in addressing the learning needs of boys in this community, where restrictions and limitations continue to be lifted and there is a return to the normal and rewarding school calendar cycle at Asquith Boys High School. Finally, I am truly privileged to be principal of Asquith Boys High School. This year has been an incredibly challenging but ultimately enriching one, where I've again learned and received so much from everyone involved in this wonderful school. Boys, staff and parents, I am always proud of everyone, as you all shall be of yourselves and what you've achieved collectively in 2022. Each and every day, I'm impressed and inspired by all the students, staff and parents that make up this wonderful educational community. Congratulations again to all of you on your efforts and your performance in 2022, and we eagerly look forward to an exciting and an amazing 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Grant. The successes that have been such a feature of the year in all the areas are due in no small part to the strong and positive leadership which you have shown, providing students at Asquith with exceptional learning opportunities in the most difficult of circumstances. Your work here is always greatly appreciated. The early years of high school are exciting, intimidating, and challenging at the same time. It is therefore important to acknowledge the students in Year 7s who have achieved success. These awards recognize students for their excellence in their studies, commitment to the school, and include awards for areas such as academic excellence, attendance, learning area achievement, and the PNC Encouragement Award. I would like to invite Mr. Kim Timmons, Year 7 Year Advisor, to announce the Year 7 Awards.
Thank you, Luke. Good morning, parents, carers, fellow teachers and students. I would firstly like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land that we're gathering on today, Guringai and Darug country, and I pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. Well, we did it. After spending the last 2 years of primary school interrupted by COVID lockdowns, we've managed to get through a full year of school, and what better way than the first year at Asquith Boys. The Year 7 cohort have filled me with immense pride this year. Their resilience, embracing of the high school experience, although I have ended the year with a few more grey hairs than I started with. This group is a bunch of talented, intelligent and hardworking young men that have me excited for what the future may bring. The whole year group should be proud of their efforts this year. I'd like to invite Ms. Dawn Kilkelly, President of the PNC Association, to present the awards, and please hold your applause till we reach the end. Okay, first award. Jairus Barakowskis, Eckersley Stage 4 Artist of the Year. Archer Barton, highly commended in 7E. Samuel de Villiers Townsend, School Service Hall Crew Award. Benjamin Donner, highly commended in 7H. Saya Anasio, first in 7S, Junior Drama Student of the Year. Haruki Fung, first in 7B, and the School Service Library Award. Jesse Holliday, highly commended in 7B. Thomas Ibbett, highly commended in 7A. Sean Jang, first in 7H. Alexander McCrackus, highly commended in 7S. No surprise on this one. Robert Morgan, Junior Musician of the Year. Darcy Nash Kraus, School Service Hall Crew Award. Riley Pierce, School Service Hall Crew Award. Jack Robson, first in 7E. Alex Stevens, PNC Encouragement Award. And Macklin Stranack, first in 7A. Please join me in congratulating the Year 7 award winners on their achievements.
Thank you, Mr. Timmins and Ms. Kilkelly. It is also important to acknowledge the Year 8 students who continue to take advantage of the exceptional learning opportunities offered here at Asquith Boys. To help us celebrate the achievements of these students, I would like to invite Ms. Elsa Young, Year 8 Year Advisor, to announce the awards.
Good morning, parents, staff and students. It has been an honour to be the Year Advisor for such a wonderful group of boys. I have thoroughly enjoyed getting to know the Year 8 cohort this year, and I'm extremely proud of the young men they are and the young men they are becoming. Whether it's been our fortnightly catch-ups at Cafe Club, walking around the playground, chatting to the boys, seeing the intense games of handball, and on occasion, a game I've never heard, hand cricket, listening to Gian's musical performances, or witnessing the high levels of engagement and effort in class, it's been a true joy to see Year 8 thrive this year. It is my pleasure to now celebrate the successes of our highest achievers. I would like to invite Mr. Jamie Roberts, representing Hornsby Lions Club, to present the awards. Please hold your applause until the end. Harvey Barton, first in football development squad, highly commended in 8A, and Eckersley's Stage 4 Artist of the Year. Talon Bickle, School Service Hall Crew Award. Logan Booth, highly commended in football development squad. Liam Debney, highly commended in Horticulture, Drummond Family Peer Tutoring Persistence and Improvement Award. Daniel Gallagher, first in 8B. Jude Goodall, first in Photography Digital Media. Nicholas Gunaratna, highly commended in 8H. Lachlan Heath, first in design thinking, highly commended in 8B. Jesse Lovell, highly commended in 8E, highly commended in music. Archie Ma, first in music. Kai O'Rourke, first in 8H. A. Riley Piper, first in 8E. Blake Scott Brannigan, highly commended in Photography Digital Media, Christopher Kent All-Star Photography Award. Gregor Szczesnecki, highly commended in Design Thinking. Bailey Thompson, PNC Encouragement Award. Ellis Tutty, first in Horticulture. And Jian Yuan, first in 8H. Please congratulate the Year 8 students on their achievements.
Thank you, Ms. Young and Mr. Jamie Roberts. We have certainly seen a lot of very deserving Stage 4 award winners so far today. The band program here at Ask for the Boys is well established, and we have a junior and senior stage band. We also have a joint concert band and wind ensemble with our sister school, Ask with Girls. I now take pleasure, for the first time since 2019 and the pre-COVID days, to introduce to you the combined concert band of Ask with Boys and Ask with Girls, who will perform to your enjoyment, Stormy Seas.
Thank you. Thank you to the Combined Concert Band for that wonderful performance. We will now move to the Stage 5 Awards and acknowledge the Year 9 students who have demonstrated excellence across a range of areas, including academic achievement, learning, citizenship, and commitment for 2022. To help us celebrate the achievements of these students, I would like to invite Mr. Rowan Bonzer, Year 9 Advisor, to announce the awards.
Right, well, Year 9. Continuing the tradition that has started for my year group since they began here, we haven't quite had a normal year. This time around, it was rain, floods, and an international superpower starting a war. Add to that the cocktail of hormones for Year 9 students, and I thought we might be in for a very interesting year. However, in true Asquith boys fashion, the boys came through with grit, determination, and a lot of heart. It has been a pleasure to see the boys mature this year, to grow and develop, and to really start to move into being young men. They have taken advantage of the wide range of opportunities we have available, which is evident in the range of award winners we have today. It's been particularly pleasurable to watch them develop and move into those leadership roles. I remain incredibly proud of all of Year 9, but today we'd like to acknowledge some of our high achievers. I would like to invite Mr. Dennis Hogan of the Rotary Club of Hornsby to please present the first awards. Matthew Argent, School Service Hall Crew Award. Elijah Austin, highly commended in Information and Software Technology. Nicholas Blanche, School Service Hall Crew Award. James Burt, Band Encouragement Award. Renil Kabuthian, first in food technology, first in visual arts. Connor Clark, School Service Hall Crew Award. Harry Dolden, first in commerce, highly commended in English, School Service Hall Crew Award. Dylan Drake, highly commended in building and construction. Benjamin Eisner, first in art metal, first in music. Nicholas Hartgrove, first in mathematics, 5.1. Oh, mate. Tyson Hong, PNC Encouragement Award. Liam Jones-Blair, highly commended in food technology. Joshua Kagerman, first in general wood. Patrick Kilkelly, School Service Hall Crew Management Award. Tanay Kumar, highly commended in mathematics 5.1. Thank you, Dennis Hogan. I would now like to invite Petty Officer David McGovern to present the next award. I'd like to invite Ms. Catherine Holder, Deputy at Asquith Boys, to present the next awards. Toby Menzies-Jackson, first in elective history, first in English, highly commended in commerce, highly commended in mathematics 5.3, and highly commended in science. Tobias Morgan, highly commended in mandatory geography and highly commended in music. Cody Morris, highly commended in general wood. Tyler Morris, highly commended in PDHPE. Benjamin O'Connor, first in physical activity and sports studies, highly commended in mathematics 5.2. Oscar Ronberg, first in information and software technology, first in science, highly commended in mandatory history and school service hall crew award. Fraser Rossington, highly commended in general metal and highly commended in visual arts. Cameron Searle, first in mandatory geography, first in mandatory history, first in mathematics 5.3, highly commended in elective history, highly commended in English, highly commended in science. Blake Tilley, first in building and construction, first in general metal. Tyler Truscott-Jones, first in PDHPE, highly commended in physical activity and sports studies. Noah Whitehouse, highly commended in Art Medal School Service Hall Crew Award. And Nathan Zinsley, first in Mathematics 5.2. Please join me in congratulating our Year 9 High Achievers.
Thank you, Mr. Bonza, Mr. Dennis Hogan, Petty Officer David McGovern, and Ms. Catherine Holder. It's wonderful to celebrate the deserving winners of Year 9 for their outstanding learning, citizenship, and commitment. It's now my pleasure to recognize the excellence of our Year 10 students across the range of areas in learning, citizenship, and commitment for 2022. To help us celebrate the achievements of these students, I would like to invite Ms. Anne Fan, Year 10 Advisor, to announce the awards.
Congratulations, Year 10, on an amazing year. It's been an honour getting to know you all better this year, and it's been impressive to watch the learning and growth you've all undertaken in such a short period of time. As individuals, many of you have had successes in your fields of interest this year. You've stepped out and impressed the community during your placements. You've taken on greater responsibilities in and out of school, and many of you have achieved outstanding academic results. I'm really excited to continue supporting you and witnessing your progress throughout your senior years of high school. I would like to invite Senior Constable Lewis Peters, Police Youth Command, PCYC, to present the first of the Year 10 awards. Please hold your applause until we reach the end. Liam Bardone, highly commended in building and construction. Cameron Benny, first equal in engineering structures. Jacob Cracknell, highly commended in Mathematics 5.1. Joel Crone, highly commended in Information and Software Technology. Jai Duncan, PNC Encouragement Award. Nathan Gates, first in General Medal, Miller Family Junior Technology Award. Cameron Jins, first in building and construction, first in PDHPE. Jensen Goodchild, first in mandatory history. Riley Heisman, first in commerce, first in English, first in food technology, first in mandatory geography, junior historian of the year. Alex Hughes, first in physical activity and sports studies. Lachlan Jeffress, highly commended in general medal, highly commended in mandatory history. Jesse Jenkins, highly commended in PDHPE. Casey Kerr, highly commended in art medal, highly commended in commerce. Samuel Kingston, first in art medal. Charlie Ma, highly commended in music, school service hall crew award. Matthew Mallett, highly commended in timber. Jack Mooney, highly commended in engineering structures, highly commended in physical activity and sports studies. Isaiah Natai Mori, first in mathematics 5.1. Liam Pierce, School Service Horcrux Award. Connor Phillip, highly commended in visual arts, Eckersley Stage 5 Artist of the Year. Douglas Price, first in visual arts, highly commended in science, the Jane Sheridan Environmental Science Award, Eckersley Stage 5 Artist of the Year. Jonathan Rangachai, highly commended in mathematics 5.2. Thank you, Senior Constable Lewis Peters. I now invite Mr. Christopher Kent, President of the Asquith Boys High School Old Boys, to present the next awards. Liam Ryan, first in timber. Gavin Saponoso, first in information and software technology, highly commended in mathematics 5.3, highly commended in science, perfect attendance award, junior science award of the year. Thank you, Mr. Christopher Kent. I now invite Mr. Michael Horro, Deputy, to present the next awards. Kai Sheba, first in mathematics 5.3, first in music, first in science, equal first in engineering structures, highly commended in English, highly commended in mandatory geography, junior mathematician of the year. Thomas Salinas, highly commended in elective history, highly commended in food technology. Talem Stranick, first in mathematics 5.2. Please congratulate all the Year 10 high achievers.
Thank you, Ms. Fan, Senior Constable Peters, Mr. Kent, and Mr. Horro. It's fantastic to see a consistent level of excellence across all learning areas. Now to our next musical item, we welcome for the first time the boys of the Junior Stage Band, who will perform the Jazz Police.
Thank you.
Thank you, boys, for that enjoyable performance. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move to the Stage 6 Awards. Let us first recognise our high-achieving Year 11 students. Having just completed Year 11 myself, I can attest to the challenges we have faced as we try to adjust to the high expectation and demands of the HSC. We will recognise and reward the Year 11 students who have best adapted to this new reality. As well as academic demands, many of our students also shine in other areas including citizenship, commitment, and mastery of practical and vocational skills. To acknowledge these students who have met these challenges head on, we will now invite Ms. Alison Gowthorpe, Year 11 Advisor, to announce the awards.
Congratulations to the 2022 Year 11 cohort on the completion of their HSC preliminary courses. Well done. My role as Year Advisor is made easy as I get to work with a group of wonderful young men who represent themselves, their families, and our school with respect and are supportive of one another. I wish them all the best as we continue on our journey towards the HSC. Today it is my great pleasure to announce our awards. I would like to invite the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddock, Mayor of Hornsby Shire Council, to present the first set of the Year 11 awards. Please hold your applause until we reach the end. Thomas Adnam, first in sport, lifestyle and recreation. Sean Antrim, highly commended in sport, lifestyle and recreation. Tyler Armstrong, highly commended in English studies. Lucas Bell, first in English studies. Frederick Burns, first in investigating science. Liam Connolly, first in music, first in work studies. Riley Koopman, highly commended in food technology. Thomas Eisner, School Service Hall Crew Award. Xander Frank, Work Placement Recognition Award in Hospitality Vet. Austin George, first in Business Studies, highly commended in Ancient History, highly commended in Modern History. Alex Guan, highly commended in Mathematics Advanced. Eli Gutman, first in Biology, first in Economics, first in Geography. Luke Hansworth, highly commended in Investigating Science, School Service Hall Crew Award. Murray Harrison, highly commended in English Standard. Thank you, Mayor Ruddock. I now invite Mr. Julian Lesser, MP, Member for Barara, to present the next awards. Josh Hegarty, first in construction VET, first in industrial technology timber, the Steve Mason Award Technology Year 11. Jasper Hildebrand, first in ancient history, first in mathematics standard, first in modern history, senior historian of the year. Daniel McPherson, first in Music 2, highly commended in Business Studies, highly commended in Physics, Band Achievement Award, School Service Hall Crew Award. Nicholas Nolan, highly commended in Sport, Lifestyle and Recreation, Work Placement Recognition Award in Construction, VET. Ali Ranjbar Zafarania, First in Hospitality VET, highly commended in Mathematics Standard. Darby Ryan, first in an English Extension 1, highly commended in Chemistry, highly commended in Geography. Thank you, Mr. Julian Lesser. I now invite Mr. Bryce Grant, our principal, to present the next awards. Ethan Scott Brannigan, highly commended in Industrial Technology Timber. Jake Sheeran, first in Chemistry, first in English Advance, first in Mathematics Advance, first in Mathematics Extension 1, first in Physics, Science Award of the Year. Jack Summerhayes, highly commended in Construction VET and highly commended in Hospitality VET. Nathan Schliger, first in Visual Arts. Casper Torash, highly commended in Economics. Roy Treves, highly commended in English Advanced, highly commended in PDHPE. Harrison Volmos Rivenera, first in Food Technology. Timothy Von Borneman, PNC Encouragement Award. Declan Wagshall, first in English Standard, first in PDHPE. Vladimir Zuif Elabasha, highly commended in Biology, highly commended in Mathematics Extension 1. Please congratulate all the Year 11 students on their achievements.
Thank you, Ms. Gowthorpe, and the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddick, Mayor of Hornsby Shire Council, Mr. Julian Lesser, Federal Member for Barara, and Councillor Tilbury. It is so wonderful to see all the deserving winners in Year 11 and acknowledge their achievements. 2020 and 2021 were tough years with the effects of remote learning and COVID lockdowns. All of the 2022 Year 12s have shown resilience to stick it out to the end of the HSC, and all of them are to be congratulated on achieving this remarkable feat under the most trying of circumstances. Year 12 academic awards were presented at the graduation ceremony, but we still need to recognise the excellence of a small few who have been nominated for Learning Area Awards for Year 12. They will be announced by the Year 12 advisor, Mr. Tom Melrose.
Good morning, teachers, students, and special guests. It's a pleasure to be back up here for my lovely graduated boys of 2022. It was very satisfying to see the cohort come together and enjoy themselves for the formal recently after an eventful few years. I'm super excited for these young men, and I'm delighted that I get one more proud moment as year advisor to announce the following awards. I'd like to invite Mr. Vo, pharmacist from Hornsby Curry Chemist, to present these awards. Please hold your applause until the end. Lachlan Donnelly, Exceptional Hizzy Student of the Year. James Gersmeyer, Senior Mathematician of the Year. Kieran Heap, Andrew Bridge Award, Industrial Technology. Rory McFarlane, Steffel Prize for Science. Colin Newland, Senior Award for Excellence in Music. Lachlan Taylor's not here for Wholesalers Prize, but Thomas Thurgate for Food and Catering Service Award for Year 12. Please wish them a round of applause.
Thank you, Mr. Melrose and Mr. Vo, and congratulations to the award winners. The Year 12 boys have been role models for us and will be a tough act to follow. It is now time for another musical item. The senior stage band will now entertain us with a performance of Le Belclair Blues. Thank you. Thank you, Senior Stage Band, for that great performance. All schools value sporting achievement, some more than others. In our school, sport is of paramount importance. Satisfying the needs for competition, physical activity, and the building of self-esteem and teamwork. Many students can achieve on the sporting field what they may not be able to achieve academically. In 2021, there were several months without sport at all, and we were very excited when we could play sport again, including the grade sport competition where we compete against other schools, as it plays a huge part in the culture of our school. Everyone gets a run, and for a small school, we inevitably exceed expectations in regional, zone, and state level sporting competitions. Here to announce the sporting awards is the grade sport coordinator, Mr. Drew Jones.
Well, thank you and good morning to all. Sport has always been an integral part of Asquith Boys High School, and we are very proud of our great history and success. Here at Asquith, we provide extensive opportunities for boys who just want to get involved in sport, catering for every individual. From boys who just want to give things a go and like the social aspect of sport, to boys who thrive on competition and go on to higher levels of representation. But it's not only on the field where sport is important. It teaches our boys about morals and ethics, leadership, good sportsmanship, and teamwork. And most importantly, it's a chance for our boys to have a lot of fun and build lifelong friendships. Right now, we're here to celebrate and recognise and reward the outstanding sporting achievements of our students throughout 2022. And what a year it has been. We finally managed to have a full year of sport, and it's been so pleasing to see the high involvement of our students at all levels. I'd now like to invite Senior Constable Lewis Peters of the Police Youth Command, PCYC, to present the first set of sport awards. If we could hold our applause to the end of this group. Our first award is actually a very special sport leadership award, which Senior Constable has donated to the school. This goes to a student who always puts his hand up and is always there if we need a referee or anything to do with sport at our school. And that is Tyler Armstrong. That one does deserve a special one, thank you. Our junior soccer, or I say football, player of the year, Harvey Barton. Our junior rugby player of the year is not with us today. He's actually playing rugby right now, I think. And that's Boston Cameron. Our futsal player of the year, Benjamin O'Connor. Our table tennis player of the year, Jordan Ruiz. The badminton player of the year, Mika Saran. Our baseball player of the year, Mitchell Lowe. And our hockey player of the year, Harry Neat. Could we please put our hands together for these award winners? Thank you very much, Senior Constable Lewis Peters. And I'd now like to invite to the stage Dr. Bill Holland, the owner of the Hornsby 24/7 Gym, to present our next group of awards, if it could hold our applause till the end. Our Footballer of the Year, and this individual will also be receiving a Zone Blue, which is a special award, as he made the New South Wales CHS seconds team this year, Zach Bovis. Our AJ Hughes Cricketer of the Year, Kyle Cruickshank. He's got his whites on. Our Basketball Player of the Year, I'm going to ask him to stay behind after this assembly as we have the staff versus students basketball game after this, and that's Liam Geiger. our Water Polo Player of the Year, Jake Sheeran. Our Senior Rugby Player of the Year, Jack Summerhayes. And after this student receives this first award, I'm going to ask him to keep on the stage and embarrass him a little bit more. This is the Nathan Sonter Memorial Lawn Bowler of the Year Award, and that's Ethan Scott Brannigan. Got a whole page dedicated to him. Because this does bring us to our Hornsby 24/7 Gym Sportsman of the Year, and that is Ethan Scott Brannigan, and we'll give him a round of applause right now. Ethan has been heavily involved in lawn bowls since he came to Asquith Boys in Year 7, but this year in particular was an amazing year. I'll read them in order here. So he was the skipper of the Sydney North Bowls team that won the New South Wales CHS Carnival. From that carnival, he was named the player of the CHS Carnival. He was named in the 2022 New South Wales CHS team. And obviously he went on to represent New South Wales CHS that won the School Sport Australia Championships versus Victoria in singles and triples. Now, his excellent performance in that also gained him selection in the All-Australian Merit Team, which was selected from that School Sport Australia Championships. I'm taking a breath because it doesn't stop there. So, he will also be receiving a Northwest Metropolitan Zone Blue endorsement. The endorsement is the second award, as he also received a Zone Blue in 2021. He might not know about a few of these ones. He's also going to be receiving a Sydney North Blue. Ethan also has received one of the most coveted and prestigious awards a high school student in New South Wales can receive in sport, and that is a New South Wales CHS Sporting Blue. And he'll be receiving his compendium here with a medal. But the most exciting part, and particularly if you ask Ethan, is that his name will now be inscribed on the honour board that sits outside the PDHPE staff room for students who have attained this honour. I am going to surprise him as well, because there's one last award that Ethan doesn't know about today, and it's my absolute pleasure to announce that he has been named the Northwest Metropolitan Zone Senior Sportsman of the Year. That concludes my awards for sport for 2022, and I look forward to 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Jones, and Senior Constable Lewis Peters and Dr. Bill Holland. This next group of awards recognises students who have demonstrated their abilities in particular areas and after a rigorous selection process have been offered scholarships. I will call on the Head Teacher of Teaching and Engagement, Ms. Susie Dedman, to announce these awards, which will be presented by Mr. Grant.
Good morning, everyone. The Mervyn Brown Scholarship Awards are named after the first principal of Asquith Boys High School, Mervyn Brown, and they reward excellence and diligence in a specific subject area. The school funds these scholarships to recognise our talented students in a range of areas. Today we are recognising three students for the Mervyn Brown Scholarships. The first is in English. Riley Heisman achieved a commendable 100% for English in Semester 1 and topped the grade in both Semester 1 and Semester 2. He loves English, especially the creative side, and is a fan of classic novels and science fiction. Riley has impressed across all subject areas and has a strong work ethic and commitment to his studies. He commits himself to help other students in math peer tutoring and plans to study Extension English and Advanced English next year. Riley is a personable student who has expressed himself eloquently in his scholarship interview and is genuinely passionate about his learning connected to English. Riley is a worthy recipient of the Mervyn Brown Academic Scholarship in English for Stage 6. Good job. Sam Kingston. Sam is a dedicated and hardworking student who hopes to become an emergency doctor when he finishes school. 2 years ago, Sam was in 8.3 maths, and he's worked extremely hard to bring himself all the way up to the top class, and he's performing at the top of that top class. He's now studying in 5.3 maths, which is the highest, and he consistently places in the top 10. He dedicates 3 hours each afternoon to study and works consistently with a tutor outside of school to improve his mathematical skills. He also manages to work at McDonald's and lead his Venturer Scout trooping activities in his spare time. Sam has helped out with a range of school events and activities and enjoys puzzles and problem solving, especially escape room challenges, which he has actually managed to get out of, he tells me, which is not easy. Sam is a worthy recipient of the Mervyn Brown Academic Scholarship in Mathematics for Stage 6. Good job, Sam. Gavin Saponoso. Gavin is a dedicated student who achieved the highest result in his year in science in semester one and also achieved excellent results across all other subjects. Gavin has perfect attendance this year, which in COVID times is extremely difficult to manage. He has a positive attitude and he strives for his personal best. He finds science fascinating and is interested in scientific research and the technological aspects of science. And his favourite area of study in science is biology, but next year he'll be studying biology, physics and chemistry, so the big three, and hopes to pursue a career in a science-related field. Gavin is a worthy recipient of the Mervyn Brown Academic Scholarship in Science for Stage 6. We now have some Kappa scholarships. Kappa, for those of you who don't know, stands for Creative and Performing Arts. And we have 2 visual arts and a music scholarship to award today. First up is Connor Phillip. Connor has demonstrated a passion for visual arts and enjoys a diversity of expressive forms in both 2D and 3D, including graphite and clay artworks, evidencing his innate talent. He has consistently produced high-quality artworks both at home and at school, and his practice goes beyond the classroom. Connor spent lockdown learning some new techniques. He sets an example for other students through his focus and hard-working classes, his work as a peer support leader, and his willingness to be involved in art projects and showcasing art across the school. Connor is a worthy recipient of the Kappa Scholarship for Stage 6. Doug Price. Doug enjoys exploring a range of different styles and mediums in art. He has an interest in designing and producing murals and caricatures, and is currently producing a series of portraits encompassing an expressive style. He has been the recipient of Artist of the Year twice at ABHS, and I think again today, and has successfully sold paintings to avid admirers of his work. He seeks to make the school a better place through his work as a prefect, peer support leader, and president of the Environment Club. He's hoping to create a mural for the basketball court in his senior years. Doug is a worthy recipient of the Kappa Scholarship for Stage 6. James Cullen. James is a talented musician whose dedication to the band program has been exceptional. He has demonstrated reliability in attending band rehearsals, and as the only tuba player, James has consistently participated in band performances, music camps, and music competitions. James is a worthy recipient of the Stage 5 Instrumental Band Scholarship. Congratulations to all our winners, and for current Year 9 students, we will be giving out information about how to apply next year, and I encourage, if you have a talent or an interest in a subject area, for people to apply. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Susie Debman and Mr. Grant. The next group of awards recognises the contribution of dedicated ABHS staff. For the last 6 years, I've been a student of this wonderful school. Over my time here, the teachers have had a big impact on the lives and learnings of my fellow students and I. I now have the honour of announcing the school staff awards that recognise two very special teachers. The first of these is Mr. Michael Blackwood. He left us halfway through this year after devoting his entire 24 years of his teaching career to the students of Asquith Boys High School. For nearly a quarter of a century, he has contributed to the education of a huge number of students who have successfully completed his senior and junior courses in timber and construction, where his students consistently achieved above school and state average results in the HSC. Over that time, he and his classes have also contributed to extensive landscaping and building projects to the huge benefit of the school and its students. This work includes shade houses for horticulture classes, the creation of extra rooms in art, careers and the library, and additional seating and retaining walls both beside the oval and in other areas of the school. This was a win-win situation, with the students acquiring the course skills and the school community gaining extra learning spaces and improved amenity. Prior to Michael's retirement at the end of Term 2, he received the Pride of Workmanship Award from the Rotary Club of Hornsby and had been a major influence in the success of Asquith Boys High School on the football field. He was an organiser and participant for all the 18 annual international football tours that have been such a feature of the school year before they were abruptly stopped by COVID. Mr. Blackwood has recently moved to Adelaide and is unable to be with us today to collect his award, but he is watching online and we will make sure your award is sent to you, Mr. Blackwood. I will now hand you over to Elliot for the second staff award.
The second of the staff awards goes to Mr. Jeff Crozier, who has been an engaging and motivated educator and an excellent teacher in two distinctly different subject areas. Originally PE trained, he undertook the challenge of retraining as a science teacher. The amazing result of his study was his appointment as a permanent teacher at Asquith Boys High School in 2019, the school where he was also a student. This training has paid off for the students of the school, with his students achieving impressive results in senior science over the first few years in which he has taught this important Stage 6 course. Jeff has passionately engaged in his two subject areas of expertise, PDHP and science, often teaching outside of the timetabled lessons and even while on leave, in an effort to ensure that his students were well prepared prior to trial and HSC examination periods. He has also recently completed training in the area of peer mediation and has developed this position within the school community to make a difference with respect to how our students interact and treat each other, ensuring that positive and collegial relations are developed. I would ask Mr. Crozier to come to the stage and collect his award, which will be presented by Mr. Grant. Please join me to congratulate and acknowledge these two wonderful ABHS staff who are being celebrated today for their work and contribution to the lives of our entire school community.
Thank you, Elliot. Worthy winners indeed.
This special group of awards recognises a group of students who have been working on a project to help promote our school values of respect, responsibility, and excellence. We ran a competition for banner design ideas, and the two winning designs were from Year 8 boys and their families. The design features from the entries were combined to form our new signs. The background design feature was an Aboriginal artwork, and a group of three Year 9 First Nations artists led a larger group who worked with First Nations artist Deanne Coe to paint the beautiful work about Dirrubbin, also known as the Hawkesbury River, that now hangs in our front office. This work forms the background layer of the banners and features symbols that represent the waters and islands of Dirrubbin. There are symbols that represent eels, fish, oysters, and journeys around the river. The School Banner Design Awards go to Evan Parise and Archie Robertson. The First Nations Artist Award go to Matthew Argent, Mitchell Heaton, and James Lomas. I'll ask them to come to the stage now, please. And congratulations again. I would now like to invite the school community to enjoy the combined wind ensemble performance of Hide and Seek.
Check 1, 2.
Trains and sewing machines.
Thank you to the combined wind ensemble for that wonderful performance. This section of our ceremony is all about recognising excellence in student leadership and citizenship. At Asquith Boys, there are rich opportunities for students to be involved in leadership, which is invaluable for later life. The following awards recognise important qualities in our students. Many of these awards are supported by local community organisations and groups. It gives us great pleasure to recognise the wonderful leadership qualities demonstrated by our students. These young men are the prospective community leaders of the future. I'll now invite Mr. Dennis Hogan of the Hornsby District Rotary Club to present the first set of the Leadership and Citizenship Awards. The Hornsby District Rotary School Captain Award recognises the commitment and dedication to every aspect of representing and leading the student body of the school. Recipient of this award is, of course, our outgoing school captain, Rory McFarlane, who has been an outstanding leader to the student body and representative of the school. He has set the bar very high in terms of his exceptional qualities as a leader. Rory has led his year group and the entire school with dignity and commitment through the trials of 2022. His efforts ensured the dignified departure of Year 12 was a positive celebration, and we are proud to have witnessed Rory's growth as a leader over the past 12 years. Please join me in thanking Rory McFarlane for his service to the school. The Mervyn Brown Vice Captain Award was initiated by Mr. Grant in 2019 to recognise the effort, commitment and dedication required to support the student leadership team and uphold the values and integrity of the school within the student body in the demanding role of Vice Captain. The outgoing Vice Captain has been an outstanding member of the student executive team, supporting the school captain, Rory McFarlane, and senior prefect, Zachary Guerra, as well as being a leader of the student body. Please join me in congratulating and thanking William Parry for his service to the school over the last 12 months. Now, Will, I'd ask you to stay on stage for a moment, please. The Sergeant Alan Pearce Prefectship Memorial Trophy Award recognises a student who has been the most outstandingly reliable prefect and provides a role model to students of Asquith Boys. Please join me to again congratulate William, who was nominated for this award by Mr. French for his excellence as a student leader. And thank you, Mr. Hogan, for your support of the school. I'll now invite the Mayor of Hornsby Shire Council, the Honourable Councillor Philip Ruddock, to present the next set of Leadership and Citizenship Awards. The Hornsby Shire Council Senior SRC Award recognises the student who leads and organises the SRC in its actions. The recipient for 2022 has shown fantastic energy and dedication, in leading the SRC with Miss Young, as well as being the co-captain of Games Club. Receiving this award for an unprecedented second year in a row is Travis Lawrence. Travis is not with us today. The recipient of the 2022 School Spirit Award has shown exceptional commitment to encouraging participation across school and community throughout his time at school. This student has demonstrated his excellent commitment through his efforts as a student, prefect, and the other Games Club co-captain. Unfortunately, he can't be with us today, but it's Travis's brother, Luke Lawrence. I hope you get something to do. The 2022 Hornsby RSL Award for Selfless Service recognises the commitment and dedication of a student who works for the good of others rather than for himself. Working to serve your community and your country is a foundational military virtue and was targeted as a worthy value to recognise in our students. This student has demonstrated both empathy and deep understanding, as well as showing support for his peers. He has done this through his good nature and kind heart and was under no obligation to act in this way. It is with great pleasure that I ask you to join me in congratulating Cooper Goodchild. And thank you, Mayor Ruddick, for taking the time to join us today. I now invite Mr. Julian Lisa, MP, Member for Barara, to present the next set of Leadership and Citizenship Awards. The Member for Barara Prize for Outstanding Citizenship Award recognises a junior student who is an exceptional citizen of the school and local community. The recipient for 2022 has shown himself to be an exceptionally committed citizen of ABHS and the local community, demonstrating a real generosity of spirit. Please congratulate Patrick Kilkelly. The Member for Hornsby, Matt Keane Citizenship Award is a prize for extraordinary citizenship in a senior student and recognises someone who is an outstanding citizen of the school community and wider local community. Please congratulate Luke Hansworth. The School Service Award recognises a student for his service to the school and community. The 2022 School Service Award goes to a student who has shown throughout his 6 years at Asquith Boys High School his commitment to school events. He led the hall crew to ensure school events are organised and supported, particularly in terms of audiovisual support. His commitment and effort around technology support has seen an enormous upgrade in the hall stand of equipment and our ability to deliver professional live-streamed events. He is an excellent role model to younger hall crew members. Please put your hands together for Jackson Atwood. Thank you, Mr. Lisa, for taking the time today. I now ask Mr. Jamie Roberts, representing Hornsby Lions Club, to present the next awards. And Barara. Okay. The Hornsby Lions Ted Tricker Leadership and School Service Award recognises a student who shows exceptional qualities in leading and working to support his school and local community. This student was also nominated for and will receive this morning his Macquarie University Year 11 Emerging Leaders Award. The Hornsby Lions TED Tricker Leadership and School Service Award goes to a student who has shown fantastic energy and commitment in his leadership. Please congratulate Joshua Hegarty. The Barara Lions Citizen and Community Service Award recognises a student who shows exceptional commitment and reliability in the service of his school community and the wider local community. We present the Barara Lions Citizenship and Community Service Award to a student who has shown the most laudable level of commitment, service, integrity and dedication. The student was also nominated for and will receive this morning his Macquarie University Year 11 Emerging Leaders Award. Please congratulate Elliot Rossington. The Asquith Boys Public School Speaking Award recognises a student for his ability to address large groups in an engaging and dignified manner. This year we have two award winners. The Junior Public Speaking Award recipient for 2022 is Davis Stanley. He was going to speak to you all today but has unfortunately been called away for other duties. Congratulations to Davis anyway in his absence. Maybe he's watching the live stream. The senior award winner is Joshua Hegarty. He's going to have to make a beeline back to the stage. Good on you, Josh. He needs no introductions to us all. And the reason for his nomination is obvious. Please join me in congratulating him. We now have four very prestigious awards provided by the Australian Defence Forces. The ADF Longtan and Future Innovators Awards. I would like to invite Councillor Nathan Tilbury to present these awards. Thank you, Jamie. I apologies for not thanking you earlier. The first of these awards is to a Year 10 student who has recently won a prize for his innovative science project which researched a water bug in local waterways at the science fair at our sister school. He is a motivated, hard-working, academic and articulate student who has dedicated himself to excellence across the 4 years of his schooling at Asquith Boys. He is a student who works hard and strives to do his personal best at all times. He is a high-achieving student who is absolutely passionate about computers and science. We wonder if he will be heading towards a career in his areas of passion in science and information technology. It's my pleasure to announce Kai Sheba as the recipient of the Year 10 ADF STEM Future Innovators Award for 2022. The next STEM Future Innovators Award winner is a Year 12 student who has engaged himself in all aspects of his studies. With dedication and excellence and demonstrated great resilience and self-motivation to maintain his standards, despite 2 years of very disrupted learning. He is highly motivated, dedicated and diligent about achieving at the highest possible level across all areas of his HSC studies, particularly in physics, chemistry, mathematics and engineering. He has achieved the top marks in the school and maintained these standards across his 6 years of high school. It's my pleasure to announce Jordan Suminen as the recipient of the Year 12 ADF STEM Future Innovators Award for 2022. This next young man is a student who demonstrated both commitment and generosity to our school. He has displayed leadership of the hall crew, is involved in scouts and supports all school community events. He is a team player who cooperates and communicates within the hall crew to stage and support school events. He demonstrates excellence in appearance and respectful behaviour and has shown himself to be a resourceful problem solver with the physical logistics of school events, as well as possessing expertise with the audiovisual workings around the school. Over the past 2 years, he has been heavily involved in our ever-improving live streaming of school assemblies. He has proven himself to be an excellent leader who has worked with fellow students to support school events during his 4 years at Asquith Boys. I wonder if this young man may have a future in audiovisual support and problem solving. He is a highly resourceful young man who collaborates well with others. We congratulate and recognise him for his excellence in teamwork, service and problem solving. The winner of the Year 10 ADF Longtown Award for Excellence in Leadership and Teamwork for 2022 is Aidan McSweeney. This final young man is a student who demonstrated exemplary leadership through his everyday actions. He is a dedicated and hardworking student who has extended himself to support his school and its events, both within and outside of school hours. He is being conspicuous by his technological innovation, efficiency, teamwork, and collaboration. He has displayed integrity in his use of his expertise in continual support of the Asquith Boys community. We congratulate and recognise Jackson Atwood and present him with the Year 12 ADF Longtown Award for Excellence in Leadership and Teamwork. Thank you much, very much, Councillor Tilbury. This part of the ceremony is where we recognise the highest level of achievement that has been attained by students in Year 11 and 12. I will ask Mr. Grant to present this final group of awards. Firstly, the Les Miller Trophy for Perseverance recognises a student who has demonstrated exceptional commitment, tenacity and perseverance. I say a student because that is normally the case. This year, however, is different. This year, for the first time I can remember, we have two winners, both of whom have shown themselves to be the most determined and exceptional young men throughout their school careers at Asquith Boys. Please congratulate both Kieran Heap and Lachlan Culverhouse. Secondly, the Year 11 Academic High Achiever Award is nominated by the Year Advisor for the student with the highest academic achievement across all of their subjects. The recipient of this award has shown himself to be a fine and dedicated student and has worked with drive and maturity to excel. No surprise, please congratulate Jake Sheeran. The Reuben F. Scarf Award is nominated by all staff and executive members for the Year 12 student who has demonstrated the most outstanding commitment across his senior years, particularly in Year 12. The 2022 award goes to a quiet and hardworking student who worked with commitment, maturity, and self-drive towards his goal to achieve success in Year 12. He excelled across all of his subjects and is well deserving of this award. Congratulations to Leo Alexander. Leo is here. Well done, Leo. The AMPOL All-Rounder Award is nominated by staff and executive members as the student of most outstanding excellence across all aspects of school life in Year 12. The award in 2022 goes to a wonderful leader, student and sportsman who has worked hard to achieve his best and present an excellent example for others to follow. Please congratulate Rory McFarlane. Just hang around for a minute, Rory. Finally, we present the 2022 Asquith Boys High School All-Round Academic Achievement Award, which recognises a fine student who has achieved at the very highest level. This year, the award, voted unanimously by staff and the executive, went to a student who has set a very high standard for others to follow, and we are proud that this young man has been a part of our school community. Congratulations again to you, Rory. Thank you, Mr. Grant. Please join me in congratulating all of today's award winners while we hand back to Luke.
Thank you, Mr. Phillip. On behalf of our school community, I would like to offer an enormous thanks to many people. First and foremost, to our principal, Mr. Grant, who has overseen many visible improvements around the school grounds over this last year. These include the newly begun painting and recarpeting, which is currently underway, a technology and infrastructure upgrade of the school library, removal and reconstruction of the retaining wall along the lower side of the school quad beside E Block, and the establishment of a native garden in this area, the ongoing opening up of the school through the removal of the unused security fencing around the canteen area, a job which was begun last Monday and is currently in progress. We also like to thank the school to work and construction programs as they have completed building a retaining wall along the oval and around the school's tree of knowledge, which is featured on the school crest. Manufacture of a new stage outside the canteen in the Palm Court area. And lastly, construction of a new outdoor reception area on the Jersey Road side of the hall. These are things which should be communicated outside of our school gates. Secondly, we would like to thank our guest presenters for being here in person with us today and our generous community supporters for their prizes. School Captain Joshua Hegarty, Vice Captain Elliot Rossington, and I would like to recognise the continuous support you have given to the students of Asquith Boys High School. Lastly from me, and on behalf of all of us up here on stage, I would like to acknowledge the staff who work behind the scenes to make this special event happen. They include, but are not limited to, Ms. Tracy Booker, Ms. Paris Christo, Mr. Manuel Cabrera and the music students, Ms. Catherine Holder, Ms. Erin Hendry, Mr. Jim French, and Mr. Kim Timmons. For the last time, I'd also like to send out an enormous thanks to Ms. Inez Beckerleg, whose huge volume of work and large contribution to the smooth running of this ceremony has been a privilege for all of us to enjoy today. Thank you also to the tech team and the crew of Ms. Linda Robson and Brad Flood, as well as the whole crew for the enormous contribution of your time and effort that you bring to these ceremonies. I now hand back to Josh for the culmination of the proceedings.
Thank you, Mr. Phillip, for the work you have done and for being the MC for this ceremony. That concludes the official part of today's proceedings. On behalf of all staff and students, I'd like to thank all of you, the parents, caregivers, and the guests of our wonderful school community, for attending in person or taking the time to join us online to recognise the superb achievements of the students at our wonderful school. We look forward to seeing you again in 2023. Goodbye, enjoy a safe and restful holiday, and have a happy new year. I now ask all present to stand until the official party has left the hall and enjoy North Point Fantasy, performed by the Combined Wind Ensemble.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us, and that concludes today's proceedings. Goodbye from all of us here at Asquith Boys, and best wishes over the coming year.